Welcome to a video on the properties of definite integrals and also the area bounded by two graphs. Let's take a look at some properties first. If we have a definite integral where the lower limit and the upper limit of integration are the same, that will always equal zero. Hopefully that kind of makes sense because the width of the interval we're considering would be zero. The second property, if we have a definite integral with the limits of integration from A to B, direction of integration, meaning we integrate from B to A, it would change the sign of the definite integral. If we have the definite integral of k times a function, we can factor out the k, and the result would be k times the value of the definite integral. A couple other quick properties. If we have a definite integral involving the sum and difference of two functions, we can break it up into individual definite integrals. And lastly, if we have a definite integral on the interval from a to b, as we have in this graph here, it would be okay for us to break this into two different integrals if we integrated from A to C and then C to B, and hopefully we can see geometrically that this would be allowed. Let's go ahead and focus on the area of a region between two curves or two graphs. And here's the idea. Again, if f and g are continuous on the closed interval and g is less than or equal to f of x for all x in the interval, then the area of the region bounded by the graphs and the vertical lines x equals a and x equals b is given by this definite integral. The key to remember here is we always have to have the top function minus the bottom function. So to find the area bounded by two intersecting graphs, we need to calculate the points of intersection by looking at the graph or by setting the two functions equal to each other. The upper and lower limits of integration will be determined by the points of intersection. Let's give it a try. We want to find the area bounded by these two functions. So step one is we have to find the points of intersection. So we're going to set the functions equal to each other and solve. So we'll move these two terms to the other side. We'd have a positive x squared plus x. And then if we subtract 3 on both sides, we'd have minus 2. This does factor. So we have two points of intersection. We have x equals negative 2 and x equals 1. These two values will help us find our limits of integration, but we still have to know which function is on top and which one is on bottom. So let's go ahead and take a look at a graph. We can see that f of x is the quadratic equation, so it's the parabola, and of course g of x is the line. Here's our value of x equals negative 2 that we found algebraically, and here's the value of x equals 1. So the area bounded by these two functions will be the definite integral of f of x minus g of x, since f of x is on top, on the interval from negative 2 to positive 1. Let's go ahead and simplify our integrand. We'd have a negative x squared minus x, and then 3 minus 1, or plus 2, will integrate with respect to x. So using the power rule, we'd have negative x cubed divided by 3 minus x squared divided by 2 plus 2x. We'll evaluate this at 1 and negative 2. So if we sub in positive 1, it would look like this. If we subbed in negative 2, it would look like this, and this simplifies to 4.5. So the area bounded by these two functions would be 4.5 square units. Let's go ahead and verify this definite integral on the graphing calculator. If we hit math and then select option 9, we can type in our original integrand, negative x squared minus x plus 2, comma x, comma negative 2 comma 1, just to check our work, and that verifies that we did it correctly. Let's go ahead and try another one. Now on this problem, I'm going to go ahead and take a look at the graph to set this up. I don't feel like solving this algebraically, but of course we can. Now the first thing we notice on this one is that the blue graph is on top at first, and then the red graph is on top on second. So this tells us we're going to have two definite integrals because it always has to be the top function minus the bottom function. So I went ahead and labeled these functions so it makes it easier for us to set up our definite integrals. The first definite integral would be on the interval from negative 2 to 0, and we can see that f of x, and we can see we'll have f of x minus g of x. Let's go ahead and label this area 1, and we'll label this area 2. So we'll label this first definite integral area 1. So for area 2, we'd have the definite integral from 0 to 2 of g of x minus f of x. Let's go ahead and simplify these. So area 1, we'd have a 3x cubed. Now the x squared terms do cancel, and we'd have negative 10x minus 2x or minus 12x, and the 2's also cancel. On area 2, we'd have a negative 3x cubed. Again, the x squared terms cancel and so do the 2's, and then we'd have positive 12x. Now the main idea here is setting these up, so I'm going to go ahead and evaluate these on the graphing calculator. So the first definite integral would be equal to 12. And the value of the second definite integral would be equal to 12 as well. Therefore, we'd take the sum of these two to find the total area. So the total area would be equal to 24 square units. Now that is kind of interesting that these two areas are the same even though they are different shapes. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you and have a good day.